Hello. We have seen that heat and mass transfer have great similarities. However, there are also a few fundamental differences. In the previous lecture, the partition coefficient has been introduced. It has been discussed that if two different liquids or gases are brought into contact, a third component in these does not have to be distributed at equal concentrations in the end. In this lecture, we will develop the theory that deals with these situations. As discussed, if two slabs of different temperature are brought into contact, heat will flow from the hot to cold side. Eventually, they will have the same temperature. Right. But what if the slabs are made of different material? That doesn't matter. The temperature will still be, in the end, the same in both slabs. This observation is so important that it forms the basis of one of the fundamental laws of thermodynamics. But with mass transfer and concentrations, it's a different story. We take now two layers of a liquid, with a component X dissolved in them. These layers are formed of identical liquids, just like we started with heat by looking at two layers of the same material. Initially, the concentration of X is higher in one layer than in the other. What do we expect in the final situation? Well, based on symmetry, we expect that in the long run, the concentrations of X is the same in both layers. Then the driving force has disappeared and no mass transport takes place anymore. So far, so good. Now we turn to X dissolved in two layers of different liquids. Now if we wait, the situation will go to equilibrium, but the concentration in both layers will in general not be the same. Otherwise, I wouldn't give this lecture, would I? In equilibrium, the temperature in a system is the same everywhere, and there is no driving temperature difference for the heat flow anymore. But with mass transfer, we need to be more careful. Apparently, a system can be in equilibrium, but not have a uniform concentration of species. So, we have to rethink our definition of a driving force for mass transfer. Working with the concentration differences between location A and B is naive. What is true is that the equilibrium, the ratio of concentration, is a given constant that only depends on the materials and on the temperature and pressure. This ratio has been introduced in the previous lecture and is called the partition coefficient. It can be found in tables and graphs. We can write this also differently and redefine our driving force for mass transfer. In equilibrium, C in A minus M times C in B will be zero, as that is exactly what the M definition states. Out of equilibrium, this difference must thus be non-zero. And this is our new definition of the driving force. Note that the old definition still holds if we don't look across an interface. Within one liquid, in equilibrium, the concentration of a dissolved species must be uniform. Actually, we then say that M equals 1. In all previous examples, we have been dealing with this case, and the old definition of driving force was fine. Also, note that if we hadn't started with heat transfer and then deal with mass transfer, but the other way around, we would now have had an easy task. All I needed to tell to you is that for heat transport, M equals 1. Okay, but how to deal with mass transfer across the interface? We're going to analyze the general case. We have two layers, A and B, with an interface formed by them. The concentrations are such that the situation is out of equilibrium as far as the two layers are concerned. But inside a layer, the concentration is uniform. The mass transfer coefficient per layer for transfer to or from the interface is k sub a and k sub b, respectively. In equilibrium, we have the partition coefficient m given. Molecules directly at the interface on each side feel a strong force to rearrange themselves, and within a very short time, the concentrations at the interface will jump to new values, such that their ratio is the partition coefficient. This is shown in the figure. Note that the interface concentration in the A phase is even higher than it was. That is very well possible, as in the final situation, more of the dissolved substance can be in the A phase. Why not, if the M value is very high? We can write the mass transfer in each phase in the usual ways. For phase A, this is phi sub A double is k sub A times, say, sub AI minus, say, sub AO. Likewise, for phase B, phi sub B double is k sub B times C sub BO minus C sub BI. We need to eliminate the interface concentration as we don't know them a priori. All we know are the bulk values CA0 and CB0. Thus, we rewrite the two equations. See the sheet. Furthermore, we know that both fluxes must be the same, as everything that flows to the interface from the B side must continue and flow into the A side. Argument? An interface has zero volume and cannot store any mass. Finally, the interface concentrations have jumped to the ratio given by the partition coefficient. If we use all these equations, we can write the mass flux from phase B to phase A as shown on the sheet. Let's inspect our new equation. First, we see that the driving force is indeed the concentration difference with the partition coefficient as prefactor for CB0. Second, there are two resistances on the left side. That is to be expected. It's like the electrical resistances in series. But notice that also here the partition coefficient slips in. This is crucial to appreciate. The resistance is no longer 1 over k, but one of the two sides get a factor m. I don't know about you, but I don't memorize where the m's are in the equation. I do know by heart that m is in the driving force and that it slips in one of the two resistances. But I always quickly do the derivation on the previous sheet. That prevents a lot of errors. And they can screw up your entire analysis, as m can be very large, but also be very small. Okay, we will not do an example here, as they are quite lengthy. Instead, we have prepared some glass plate examples where we will discuss how to use the new knowledge. Please check them out and try some exercises for yourself. As always, start with a good drawing. So, that's all for now. See you at the glass plate.